Son, that was the best guitar solo I've ever heard. I'd like to sign you to my label.
What? Really?
Kid, you're gonna be a star. A guitar star.
You darn right!
Brent, snap out of it. Are you fantasizing about guitars again?
God, my dad, the rock star premieres make me want to rock out.
Well, there's another one today at 5:30, 4:30 Central.
All right!
From New Jersey, live from Times Square in the heart of New York City. This is You Pick Live.
Infusion of You Pick goodness for you today. Candace is jumping up and down. She can't contain herself, including a special performance by Brie Larson.
Yeah!
Bring it in, Candace.
And,
yeah!
And we've got a brand new episode of My Dad the Rockstar at 5:30, 4:30 Central today and every day this week.
But first, if you find yourself talking to a dude in his underwear carrying a microphone, chances are you're making a SpongeBob personal pick.
In New York, the odds are probably about like 5 to 1 on that, because I think a lot of people here dress like that.
That's very true, Candace. A wise observation of you. But Pigboy got this one while he was hanging out at the Super Bowl, and I'm pretty sure he was the only guy there wearing his underwear on the outside.
Let's see.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Joey Harrington, who plays for the Detroit Long-Toed Tigers. Details. Dude, you got a SpongeBob personal pick for us?
My personal favorite SpongeBob episode is when SpongeBob and Patrick go and babysit Sandy's caterpillar.
Oh, dude, that is such a good episode. Oh, man, wait till you see this one. Roll it.
Yo, remember.
Out of my way, because I'm going somewhere. This is not where I want to be. You can say what you want, you can tell me I'm wrong. La-di-da, la-di-dee.
Hey, this is You Pick Live. We are here with singer-songwriter Brie Larson.
Woo!
Brie, you're 15 years old.
Sorry.
Thank you, Brie.
No problem.
You're 15 years old, you write your own songs, you sing your own songs, you play the guitar. What's that process like for you? And when did you start it all?
Yeah, actually I started writing songs when I was 12 and found a guitar and thought it was just the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen. So I was starting to learn how to play that. And writing songs is a really, really fun process, and it's cool to get to work with new artists and new writers and everything like that. So it's a very fun process to be
able to. Now, how do you go about it? Do you write your songs first and then you write it to the music, or do you just play along with the guitar and figure out the music and then write the lyrics afterwards?
I've done it in all different sorts of ways. Like when I first started writing, I just did it by myself and it was just me and a guitar. And then it kind of just started to evolve, and it's fun to work with other producers who have different ideas and different ways of learning. And you kind of get different songs when you work in different kinds of ways.
So now you've been in the industry since you were really, really young. What's it like being a teenager in this industry?
No,
it's, growing up in it.
It's really fun because you get to do experiences that most people don't get to do, like being here at You Pick. I mean, jeez, I'm like the luckiest girl in the world. I watch the show on TV, so getting to do stuff like that and meeting celebrities and stuff like that, I still get starstruck just like everybody
else.
Sure.
We do too here. So I think we have a question in the lounge.
Speaking of starstruck,
oh, no.
How would you feel about adding a drummer / vocalist / wicked guitar player to your band?
You're serious?
Totally.
Okay, I'm thinking I've got two guitar players. I'm sorry.
So you're saying there's room for a third? I'm in.
Yeah, Brent, I think that's a no. Sorry. Okay, thanks, Brie. We've got more coming up. The Nick Quick Pick is coming up next, so stick around. And we have a live performance by Brie.
Hey, you're watching You Pick Live, and it's time to see if Brie Larson can handle the overwhelming power of the Nick Quick Pick. That's it. Electric guitar, thank you. The season record is a 3-way tie right now with 7. I like that. There's 13 questions here. You got 30 seconds to answer as many questions as you possibly can. I'll ask you the question. You answer it. You immediately pick another number. I'll ask you another question.
Got it.
You got it?
I got it. I'm here to win.
Here's how it works. Give me 30 seconds on the clock. Bing! Thank you very much. Ready? And pick!
Five.
Sing it. A bass line from one of your songs.
Doom, 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 doom.
Pick.
13.
13. What was that? Anyway, put it on. Giant sunglasses. Put them on. Pick.
Seven.
Seven. Imitate it. A furious giraffe. What? Pick. What?
Six.
Philosophy. Take on the world or take a nap?
Take a nap.
Take a nap. Pick.
Four.
Four. Say something nice about bullies.
Bullies are nice because they make you stronger.
Okay, pick.
12.
12. Finish it. My ideal pet would be?
A unicorn. 11.
A unicorn. Six. You got six. What did I? Six. Nice job. No. She's so upset. Don't cry for me, Argentina. We'll be back with more Bree and more You Big Live after this. Just play your SpongeBob personal pick. Yeah, I'm just getting ready for the Boys versus Girls Challenge. It's important to visualize victory if you want to achieve it.
Yeah, well, I'm visualizing something, too. Check out Uncle Plasma.
What's that in third place?
Oh, that's the amoeba. They have no gender, so they always finish last in the Boys versus Girls Challenge.
So I am guaranteed a victory. Brent and Amoeba are necking something. Yeah, it's Brent again!
The Boys versus Girls Challenge. Okay, here's how today's challenge is going to work. We have Brent and Candace here on the skateboards behind me. They have their loungers playing on their respective teams. They are going to pull them down the hallway. As you can see, there are plenty of items with different numbers on them. The numbers indicate point value. As Brent and Candace get pulled down the hall, they'll collect as many points as they can. Now they need to hold on to as many as they can. Once they cross this red line, we will tally up the points to see who the winner is. Okay, are we ready?
Yes.
You must hang on to all items.
Okay.
On your mark, get set, go.
Easy, slow. Down. Stop.
Heated battle here.
Okay. Stop.
Okay.
Okay, go. Give it a tambourine.
Stop.
Neither team has crossed the finish line yet.
Okay, you ready?
Okay, we're gonna now total up the point values. Okay.
I dropped some of my numbers.
Okay, well, you don't get them. You have to have them across the finish line.
The numbers?
Oh.
The numbers came off.
Oh, okay, hold on. The numbers came off.
We got three, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Ten, and what do we have here?
Right there.
13. Ooh, and five is 18 for the boys. 18 for the boys. Okay, Candace, we have 3 is 6 is 9. 9 and 3 is 12. Oh, no.
This was a 3.
This was a 3.
You can find it somewhere down there. I saw
12,
it.
12, so this is 15. And 5 makes 20. The girls are together. Yeah. The Boys versus Girls Challenge. And let me tell you, my math is outstanding.
So close.
Here's a more premiere of My Dad the Rockstar, only on You Big Live. Good job, guys.
Hey, you're watching You Pick Live. Everyone give it up for Brie Larson.
Yeah. I get out of my way because I'm going somewhere. This is not where I want to be. You can say what you want. You can tell me I'm wrong. La-di-da. Get off my back, stop saying that, cause I'm not afraid of heights. I may never get where I'm going, yeah, but then again I might. You can get inside my head, can't be my safety net. I'm standing on the edge, yeah, I know it's a long way down. But you can't walk the wire for anybody else. I might hit the
decisions on the show. Who's going to stand behind the prize wall? Who's going to wash Pick Boy's tights?
So we thought we'd give you a little behind-the-scenes look at the decision-making process here on You Pick Live. Mm-hmm. Hey, Pick Boy, can you come in here for a second?
Guys, check out what I found. Ice cube tray. Now I can have an infinite number of tomato juicicles.
Great, thanks for that. Okay, decision time. Who's going to hose down the cow after the show?
Oh, man, not again.
And who's going to taste the bucket of yuck?
This is totally unfair.
That's how we always do it, Pick Boy.
Well, you know what? I think we should come up with a different way of doing it, because that way the whole touch your nose thing doesn't take into account for people who are preoccupied with other things, like infinite number of tomato juicicles.
Okay, well, if you don't like it, then why don't you come up with something new, Pick Boy?
How about we just, like, point at the person we want? That way we have a democracy.
Okay, let's try it.
Let's try it.
Who's gonna shave our stage manager Scotty's back and feet?
Yes! 100% democracy!
Yeah!
Scotty!
Oh, that method is much better.
I agree. Now let's check out the rest of My Dad the Rock Star premiere. Yeah!
The Nick.com thing is coming up next, and it's an easy way to make your voice heard.
Oh, finally! I sent this messenger pigeon out like a month ago. Tell Candace my vote. What, the silent treatment? Oh, that's very mature.
Pick Boy, if you want to vote for the Nick.com pick, just point and click your way to the You Pick Live homepage and make your pick. It's really easy.
Well, you're still not off the hook, Clarence. Where have you been?
The Nick.com pick is coming up next.
Don't look at me like that, Clarence.
You've been avidly clicking away all day, choosing between My Life as a Teenage Robot, Chalk Zone, and Rugrats. The votes have been tallied, and Madison, Bridget, and Eric are here to help us reveal the winner.
Now, to present the results of your votes, they each have electoral balloons. Right. Now, the amount of air in each balloon represents how many of you voted for the Nicktoon.
All right, let's show them, Candace. You're working it out here.
All right, so let's start with you. 38% of you voted for My Life as a Teenage Robot. 25% of you voted for Chalk Zone, and 37% of you voted for Rugrats.
It looks like it's My Life as a Teenage Robot is the winner. Now, as you know, if you love electoral balloons, you must set them free. Set them free, release the balloons. Woo! Yeah, that's like,
right,
wow, that was fun.
Planning. Here's My Life as a Teenage Robot.
Always more fun than I think it's going to be. Why are you sitting there, dude?
Well, I realize that our fan of the week, Eric, since he's only a photo, has no chance of punching through the wall.
So?
Okay, well, I'm teaching him a punch-free method so he can get what he wants.
Oh.
All right, now, Eric, first of all, you're going to need to sign this petition, and this will free the bucket of bucks, okay? Then I'll mail it to the prize wall later, okay? And then you need to chant, "Hey, ho, let the bucket of bucks go!"
Ooh. Silent sit-in protest. Very good. All right, the prize bowl punch is coming up next, and here's one of the prizes you could win.
You could win a Shark Tale DVD from DreamWorks Home Entertainment.
Stay right there.
Rick! That's it.
Jab. Let's get our resident Vicky superhero out here.
Oh, Pick Boy!
Come stand next to Candace right here.
Hi, what's your name?
Sierra.
Sierra, okay, Sierra, here's what you could possibly win.
You could win the Bucket of Bucks, a chance at the Bucket of Yuck, or a Shark Tale DVD from DreamWorks Home Entertainment.
Okay, Ladgers, which number should she punch? Okay, Sierra, go punch the number you want.
Oh, Sierra, come on.
Oh, she's thinking about it. Come on, punch one. Punch one, whichever one you want.
retail DVD from DreamWorks Home Entertainment.
Cue cards, and now we can enjoy them at a slower pace. Key Grip, Claus Falcon. Boom Mic Operator, Reginald McDoo. Assistant Director, Baldo Gomez.
Very nice of you, Candace, but you're not going to get through them all, pal.
Try to be more like Norris Smith. Best Boy Norris Smith.
Oh, that was me.
I think that's all I have. I don't know where they are.
I look good. Hey, you're watching UPIC Live. It's time for What Up?
You are correct.
Yes, I know. Thank you. Our top story comes from Chow Gage, who posts, "All my friends think I'm weird. Is this something to be proud of?" Well, Chow Gage, as long as your weirdness doesn't hurt anyone, there's certainly no reason at all to be ashamed. Weirdness adds refreshing diversity to a world that can be sadly conformist. Take it from me. Weird is just another way of saying, yeah, sure, bye-bye, weird, bye-bye, weird. If this belief makes me weird, then guilty as charged. Candace?
Thanks, Brent. In science news, French researchers have developed a mirror that uses a computer program and information collected around your home to project what you may look like in the future. Ooh. Back to you, Prince.
Don't worry, Candace. There's treatment for that. It's time for more weirdness with a weird fact of the day. Did you know that cows can walk upstairs, but it's physically impossible for them to walk downstairs? Cow.
Bet you can't go one more stair.
Oh, well. That's it for What Up in Your World. Here's our fan of the week, Eric, with an important message.
Coming up next, Rugrats.
And the winner for Best Supporting Keytar in a pick-themed interstitial program goes to... Brent Popolizio.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I don't know what to say. So many wicked keytar solos. And
Brent,
finally,
Brent,
you guys are the picky.
Finally. It's your line.
Finally.
Oh. The last word is next. You and your keytars.
I want to thank Tony and Tina. Thank you.
Things, service, security.
Episode of My Dad, the Rock Star at 5:30, 4:30 Central.
And don't forget about the All Grown Up premiere tomorrow night at 8:30, 7:30 Central. It's all about Tommy's first kiss.
Wow, that's scary. 2 days. We got Jimmy Neutron coming up next, but first there's Kelly, Danny, and L'Oreal with the last word.
Take it away.
Hey, who's past his class in Shore Road School?
Yeah!